We continue now at the top of Daf Pei Chesem and Beis and Maseches Pesachim. This is Pesachim Daf 88b. Gemara here is in the middle of the Machlokas between Beis Hillel and Beis Shammai. What's the status of an individual who's Chetzio Eved, he's half Eved, and Chetzio Ben Chorin, he's half free? So Beis Hillel had just said that he works one day for himself and he works one day for his master, he alternates days. And Beis Shammai replied, Tikantam is Rabbo, you fix the situation in terms of his master. Ves Atzmo lo Tikantam, but you haven't fixed his own situation. Rashi says, Tikantam is Rabbo, Sheino Mafsid Klum in Haroilo. The master's getting everything that he deserves to get. He has half ownership and he gets half the work. However, Ves Atzmo lo Tikantam, Matayolov, you haven't fixed his situation. Why not? Lisa Shivcha Eino Yachol, he can't marry a Shivcha, Shekvar Chetzio Ben Chorin, because half of him is a free person. Lisa Bas Chorin Eino Yachol, he can't marry a free person, Shadayin Chetzio Eved, because half of him is an Eved. Yevatel, so then you'll say he doesn't get married at all. He should just be Mevatel, not do anything. Valo lo nivro, lamela lapiria veribya, but wasn't the world only created for piria veribya, for being fruitful and multiplying? Shenemar, like the Pasuk says, lo sobro, lo sheves yitzara. The world was created only for this idea of to further the creation. Elam ibn Tikkun Olam. So therefore, Beis Shammai say, in order to fix the world, in order to fix this situation, for Tikkun Olam purposes, Kofen es Rabo v'oso so ben Chorin, you force the master and you make him fully free, v'chosef shtar al chatzi damav, and you write up a shtar, a document on half of that value. V'chazru Beis Hillel lahoros k'Beis Shammai. And in the end, Beis Hillel retracted and said like Beis Shammai. So that's where you see over here that Beis Hillel, that's the Mishnah Achrona. Beis Hillel say, no, we agree with Beis Shammai. And effectively, when you have an individual who's Chetzio Eved and Chetzio Ben Chorin, he is going to be freed. That other half of him is going to be freed. Rashi over here says, Lisa Shivcha Eino Yachol, he can't marry a Shivcha. Detzad Cheiros Aserba, that's the side of him that is free, cannot marry a Shivcha. Dechsiv, because the Pasuk says, Lo Yia Kadesh, Lo Yisavitza Amma. Again, a person cannot marry a woman who is a Shivcha, who is a slave, so that's why that's not a possibility as well. And the Gemara continues with the Mishnah, Ha'omer La'avdo. Let's say a person says to a servant, Tzei v'shochot olay es ha-pesach. He says, go and shecht on my behalf, shecht the Korban Pesach. So shachat gedi yochal, if he shechts from a goat, he eats from the goat. Shachat tele yochal, if he shechts for him a sheep, he eats from the sheep. Shachat gedi utle, now if he shechts a goat and a sheep, yochal min arishon, then he should eat from whichever one was shechted first. Now Rashi over here explains. Shachat gedi yochal rabo mimenu, he shechts a goat, the master should eat from there. V'yavagav derogil betzle. The chiddush over here is, even though this master regularly, normally, would be accustomed to doing a sheep, tekeven delo parish le'ole asamech, because since he didn't explain what kind of animal to shecht, what really the chiddush of the mission is, the master was telling the servant, whatever you choose, that's good with me. And then if he shechts both of them, yochal min harishon v'asheni yisarif, eat from whatever was shechted first, the second one will be burned. Now the Mishnah continues, Shachach ma'amarlo rabo. Now what if the servant forgot what the master said? As Rashi says, Shachach ma'amarlo rabo, Shapiro shlo gedi otzlev, is a shachach. He actually told him, I want you to shech the gedi. I want you to shech the tle. He told him a specific animal, but now the Eved forgot. So what should he do in such a situation? Ketzad yasa, what should he do? Yishchat tle'u gedi. What he should do is, he should shech the sheep and a goat. V'yomer, and he should say as follows, Im gedi amar li rabbi, if my master told me to shecht the gedi shalo, then the gedi will be for him. Utele shali, and then the sheep will be mine. It will be for me. V'im tele amar li rebi, and if my master said to shecht the sheep, hatele shalo, then the sheep will be his. Ugedi shali, and the goat will be mine. Now, what does it mean that the animal will be mine? Rashi over here points out, utele shali of a gemara parach. The gemara will ask, mashe kon eved kon arava. Whatever an eved acquires really belongs to the master. Umenale ledidei. So then, what does that exactly mean that it's going to be his? It doesn't really make any sense. And the Mishnah concludes, shachach rabo ma amar lo. Now, what if the master himself forgot what instruction he gave? So then Shnei and Yatzu lebeis hasreifa, then both animals just have to be burned. Upiturin milasos pesach sheni. However, they are potter from making a pesach sheni. In other words, they fulfill their obligation of Karban Pesach. They just can't eat from that Karban Pesach. Rashi over here explains, shachach ravo ma'amar lo v'zekvar shachar ashnayim. This guy shechted both animals. The master doesn't even remember which one. Shneim yotze lebeis hasreifa delo yedia hai dehai v'hai dehai. You don't know which one belongs to whom. Vein pesach nechol elo lemenuyav. And the halach is a Karban Karban Pesach is only allowed to be eaten for that who it's appointed for, so we have no idea who to give which animal to. Upturin mi Pesach Sheni, however, they are putter from Pesach Sheni. And Rashi explains, the Shchito Zrika Mal Yossi, because the Shchita and the Zrika, they're perfectly good. Chada Ahai v'chada Ahai. One is on behalf of the master, one is on behalf of the servant. V'kame Shmaya Gali, in heaven they know who was shechted for, which animal belongs to whom. They just don't know in order to be able to eat the animals. That's a problem in terms of eating the animals, but in terms of the offering, in terms of the shechita and the zrika, that's all going to be good. Gemara now says, Pshita it is obvious, shachat gedi yochal afagav derogel betleh. If he shechted again, the eved shechted from a gedi, even though he normally does a tleh, it's perfectly fine, he can have the gedi. Shachat tleh yochal, if he shechted a tleh from, he can eat it. Afagav derogel begedi, even though he normally does a gedi. Ela shachat gedi utleh, but what about that next line in the Mishnah, which says if he shechted on his behalf a gedi and a tleh, yochal min arishan. So it says that the owner takes whatever eats from whichever one is first. How is that possible? Vatanya, but we learned in a brisa, ein nimnin al shnei psachim keechad, you can't be appointed on two carbon pesachs at once. That's not possible. So how is this going to be considered an effective shechita that he can eat from? Rashi says, Vatanya, ein nimnin al shnei psachim keechad, lecho b'shas achilam me'echad me'am shiyirtze. He can't just eat from whichever one he wants. Dein breira, because there is no breira. We don't say retroactively it turns out this is the carbon pesach. V'chiboy l'meichal dilma b'shas shechita lo havedaito le. If he wants to go eat it now, but maybe at the time of shechita he wouldn't have wanted this particular animal. Hilkach lo achil, therefore he shouldn't eat at all. V'zeh shehimnes rabo al shnei psachim. So in our case over here, where the eved appointed his master, registered his master to two carbon pesachs, the rabo samacholav, and the master relied on him. Heich yochal min arishon. How is he eating from the first one? How does that line make any sense? So the Gemara answers, Masnis, and our Mishnah is talking specifically in a case, B'melech u'malka, with a king and a queen. And Rashi over here explains, B'melech u'malka shetuluyin al avdeyan, a king and queen, they rely on their servants, V'ein makbidin al sudas, and they don't really care what particular meal they're served, im gedim, im tulaim, they don't care if it's goats or sheep, hilkach ein kan din breira, therefore there's no breira over here. We're not trying to retroactively figure out which one they preferred. The tarvayu nicholei, they'll be happy with either one, they're happy with both. L'fikach yochal min arishan, therefore, they are going to eat whichever one was shechted first. Because if they don't care, it turns out that the first one is the one they fulfill their obligation. The second one was shechted for no reason, but it turns out that the first one is perfectly good for them. And the Gemara continues with a brisa that supports this. V'atanya, as we learned in a brisa, a nimdin al shnei psachim ke'echad, you're not allowed to be appointed, be registered on two karban pesachs at once. Umaisa b'melech u'malka, but there was a situation, there was a story with a king and a queen. Sha'amru le'avdehem, they said to their servants, tzu v'shachtu aleinu es ha'pesach, go, shecht on our behalf the karban pesach, v'yotzu v'shachtu alein shnei psachim, and they went, they shechted on their behalf two karban pesachs, bo v'shalu es ha'melech, then they went and they asked the king. Amar Lemi said to them, "Luchu v'shalu es hamalka, go ask the queen what she prefers." Bo v'shalu min hamalka, so they went. They asked the queen. Amar Lahem, she said to them, "Luchu v'shalu es Rabbi Gamliel, ask Rabbi Gamliel what we should do in this situation." Balu v'shalu es Rabbi Gamliel, so they came and they asked Rabbi Gamliel. Amar Lahem, he said to them, "Malko melech the daiton kalo alein yochlu min arishon." He said, when it comes to a king and a queen, their das is kal, meaning they don't care that much. It doesn't matter. So therefore, whichever one was shechted first, that's the one that they should take. Anon, but when it comes to us, we do care. Lo necha, lo min arishon, v'lo min hasheni. We would not eat from the first one or the second one because there's a certain hakpada. We don't know which one we really would have preferred. At the time of the shechita, it wasn't known. V'shuv pamachas, there was another story. Nimtzes halta bebeis hamitbachayim. There was found a halta. Rashi over here says, halta echod mishmona shrotzim hamitamin b'magon. The situation was, one of the eight shrotzim is called the halta, and it's metame. When it touches things, it causes tumma. Uvikshu letame shayusvur in shemesa. They thought the sheretz was dead, so they wanted to know whether it had caused tumma or not. So they found this halta, they found this lizard, bebeis hamitbachayim. Again, they found it in the kitchen. Uvikshu letame kol asudakula. They wanted to know, is the entire meal tame now? Bo v'shalu es hamelech, so they came, they asked the king, Amar Lehem, he said to them, l'chu v'shalu es hamalka, go ask the queen, bo v'shalu es hamalka, they came, they asked the queen, Amar Lehem, she said to them, l'chu v'shalu es Rabbi Gamliel, go ask Rabbi Gamliel, bo v'shalu oso, they came and they asked Rabbi Gamliel, Amar Lehem, he said to them, beis hamitbachayim roseichot sonin, in this kitchen, was it found in something that was hot, or was it found in something that was cold? Amru lo, they said to him, roseach, it was found in something that was hot. Amar Lehem, he said to them, l'chu v'tilu alea kos shel tzonin. He said, go pour on the lizard, pour a cup of cold water on it. Halchu vitilu alea kos shel tzonin. So they poured on the altar, they poured a cup of cold water, verichshan, it started moving. In other words, he was able to show by this that it wasn't actually dead, so it wasn't actually tameh yet. V'tihe Rabbi Gamliel kol hasu'udakul. And based on this, Rabbi Gamliel was able to purify the entire meal. He said the whole meal was pure. Nimsa melech toli v'malka. The Gemara concludes, you see that the king really relied on the queen. V'nimsas malka tuluyah b'Rabbi Gamliel. And you see that the queen really relied on Rabbi Gamliel. Nimsas kol hasu'udah tuluyah b'Rabbi Gamliel. And you see that the entire meal was really dependent on the decision of Rabbi Gamliel. And then again, the Mishnah said, Shachach ma sha'amar lo rabo v'chulu. It said in the Mishnah, if the servant forgot what the master said, he should check both kinds of animals, the tla and the gedi, and he should say, whatever my master said will belong to him, and I'll take the other one. So the Gemara asks, Shali, it's going to be mine. What do you mean? How can the servant say it's mine? Ma shekona evid kona rabo. Whatever the evid acquires is in any case acquired by the master. So Amar Abaye, so Abaye says he does it as follows. Holech etzel roe harogil rabo etzlo. He goes to a shepherd who the master generally buys from this particular shepherd. Denichole betakanta derabe. The shepherd really wants to help out the master. Umakni le chad minayu al menas shein l'rabo reshusbo. And then what the shepherd can do is he can sell him two animals and he'll say, one of these animals will belong to you and I sell it to you, the Eved, on condition that it doesn't belong to the master. So now it will entirely belong to the Eved. Rashi over here explains betakanta derabe in order to fix the situation for the master. Shein lo takon acher. There really is no other solution. They have to do it in this fashion where one of them will go to the master and one will go to the Eved. Why? Maybe you would have thought they have a simple solution. If he wanted a gedi, then the gedi will be the carbon pesach of his, and then the tle will just make it a carbon shlamim. V'im tle amar li rabbi, and if my master said a tle shalo, gedi shlamim, then maybe you could just say the tle will be his and the gedi will be a shlamim. That's not a good solution. Kidim efarsh l'kaman, that's going to be explained later on. We'll see in the Gemara later on why designating the other one as a shlamim is not going to be a good solution. So that's why this is really the only solution you can do, and you go to this shepherd who can help out and say, I'm going to be makna to you on the condition that it doesn't belong to the master. And the Gemara continues quoting the Mishnah, Shachach Rabo Mashamar Lo V'chulu. Let's say the master forgot what exactly he himself said. He forgot whether he asked for a gedi or a tle. So then in that situation, the Mishnah said that they both have to be burned, but they're still Yotze. They don't have to bring Pesach Sheni. They're Yotze with that carbon Pesach. Amar Abaye, so Abaye says, Lo shanu ela shashachach achar zrika. This is only true if they forgot after they did the zrika. So meaning at the time they did the shchita and the zrika, those were done properly. Devo'idna de'izrik dam havechazi la'achila. At the time you did the zrika sadam, it was fit to be eaten. And therefore the shchita and the zrika are considered properly. They fulfill the obligation of Karban Pesach. They just can't eat from it. Avol shachach lefnei zrika. But if the owner forgot already before zrika, so at the time of the zrika, you don't even know which one you're doing the zrika, which one's a Pesach. So in that case, when the Zrikas Adam was done, it wasn't even fit to be eaten. So in that case, Chayovin Lasos Pesach Sheni. Then they're going to need to bring Pesach Sheni. That's not going to be considered a good Zrika. If the Eved is doing a Zrika on both a Gedi and a Tleh, and not only is the Eved not sure which one belongs to whom, but even the owner at the time has no idea whether he asked for a Gedi or a Tleh. So in that case, it's already Lo Chazi L'Achila. If it's Lo Chazi L'Achila, if you're doing a Zrika that you know is not going to be able to be eaten, so that's going to be problematic. And the Gemara continues, Zika demasni lo abraisa. Some people have this statement of Abaye, who makes a distinction between la'achar zrika and lefnei zrika. It's on the following case and the following braisa. Chamisha shenesarvu oros pischei and zebezayeh. Five people, and the hides of their carbon pesachs all get mixed up with each other. V'nimtza yabeles bechod mehen, and we find a wart, we find some kind of a blemish, which really makes it puzzle, on one of these five hides. So now you have no idea which carbon pesach was puzzle. So kulan yotz and lebeis hasreifa, all of them have to be burned. You don't know which one's not a good carbon pesach. Upeturin milasos pesach sheni. But the fact of the matter is, they already offered this carbon pesach, so they're potter from doing pesach sheni. They just can't eat from these karbonas. And Amar Abaye, and Abaye made a statement on this particular brice of the same statement. Lo shanu ela shenesarvu lachar zrika. This whole halach is only true if they get mixed up after you did the zrika. Devo'idna de izrik dam miyo havechazi lachila. Because at the time you did the zrika, nothing was mixed up. Everybody everybody knew that they were doing a zrika on their particular animal. So at that moment, it was chazila achila. Aval nisarvu lifnei zrika, but if everything gets mixed up before they even do the zrika, so they know at the time they're doing the zrika that it's not going to be edible. Then chayav in lasos pesach sheni. Then already they're going to need to do pesach sheni, because if you do a zrika again at the time of the zrika, knowing, realizing that everything is mixed up, one of these has a blemish, you won't be able to eat from it, that already is not going to fulfill your obligation. You're going to need to do pesach sheni. And the Gemara elaborates, man de masnia masnisen kol shekena braisa. If you make Abaye's statement, if you say that Abaye's statement was made on our Mishnah, then it's certainly going to be true that Abaye would make the exact same statement on the braisa. Man de masnia braisa, but if Abaye made the statement on the braisa, avala masnisen lo, but on the Mishnah he would not make such a statement. Kevon dekshayrin ninu, because in the case of our Mishnah, the Karban Pesachs, you have two Karban Pesachs and you forget and you don't know which one is for whom, but at the end of the day, they're kosher Karban Pesachs. And the fact of the matter is, if the guy would remember which one belonged to which, it would be perfectly fit for Achila. So Kame Shmaya Galia, we say that in terms of Shamayim, Shamayim knows which one belongs to whom, and therefore, again, if Abaye made the statement on the Braisa, he would not make it on the Mishnah. In the case of the Mishnah, they would have fulfilled their obligation even if the forgetting took place before the Zrika. Amar Mar, the master said, Upiturin Milasos Pesach Sheni. Again, we said that they're potter from doing Pesach Sheni. They have fulfilled their obligation. So the Gemara asks, Vaika Chad, Delo Nafik. What do you mean they fulfilled? This is going on the Braisa. It said that you have these five animals, one of them has a blemish. So it said that they've fulfilled their obligation. But one of them, one of the five people, certainly did not fulfill the Karban Pesach obligation because it had a blemish. So what's going on? So the Gemara says, Mishum de lo efshar. The Gemara answers no, because there's no other possibility. Hechi li'avid, what are we going to do over here exactly? We don't know which one of these five individuals has not fulfilled the obligation. So what's the solution? Lesi kol chad v'chad pesach, if every single one is going to bring another Karban Pesach, kamay sichulin la'azara, so then what's going to end up happening is you're going to bring chulin li'azara because four of them already had a kosher Karban Pesach. Darbo minayu avdilu, because four of them have already brought the Karban Pesach properly. So you can't, that's not going to be a solution. Now, lesi kulu chad pesach, maybe another solution you'll say is let all of them bring one Karban Pesach. But that's also not a good solution because nimtza pesach nechol shelo leminuyev, because in that case, what's going to happen is it's going to be eaten by people who really aren't registered properly for it. Rashi over here says, shelo leminuyev she'elu shekvar yatsu ein minyonim klum, because anybody who was already yotzei their obligation with the first time, registering them is not going to count for anything, so that's not going to work either. So the Gemara continues to ask, hi mai, what kind of problem is this? We have a different solution. Nesi kol chad minayu pischo, let everybody bring a Karban Pesach v'nisni, and everybody will make a following tonight. They'll make a condition. V'neima, they'll say as follows, ididi balmum, if mine was the one with the blemish, haidai si hashta na have a Pesach. What I'm bringing now will be a Karban Pesach. V'didi tam, but if I already brought a good Karban Pesach, if mine was one of the good ones, haidai si hashta na have a shlomim. What I'm bringing now will just be a regular Karban shlomim. And the Gemara to that says, lo efsha, that's not a possible solution, and we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Peites Amud Aleph.